Hey everybody, welcome to Jaydog Outdoors. For today's video, I'm referring back to the archives again for a look at Peaks of Otter in Bedford, Virginia. This was all shot in the fall, so you're going to see some beautiful color, learn a little bit about the attractions there, and discover the two most important factors for leaf change in the fall season. Hope you like it.
No one knows for certain when the first visitors came to the Peaks of Otter. But for more than 8,000 years, people have traveled through the area, searching for both their livelihood and recreation. Native Americans passed through the area while hunting, and the earliest European settlers began arriving in the mid-1700s. By 1834, the first inn had opened. And by the turn of the century, the Peaks of Otter had become a popular tourist destination.
The Peaks of Otter freezing with Ranger. Is it Ranger?
Ranger.
Ranger Jamie Parker, who's a tech graduate, by the way. Jamie, tell us a little bit about the Peaks of Otter. I've been here before, but I don't know a lot about it. Like, give me five cool things about the Peaks of Otter.
Five cool things. Well, definitely number one is the hiking. Number two, it's a great area for family picnics. Number three, the views. From one of the top of our mountains, you have a 360-degree view of the area. And on good, clear days, you can see 60 miles into West Virginia. Number four, the wildlife. We have white-tailed deer that are more than plentiful, and a lot of black bear that get seen throughout the area, and wild turkeys. And number five, just the fact that you're in a national park is a good enough reason.
In the valley formed by Sharp Top, Flat Top, and Harkening Hill, the area has a lodge and restaurant, visitor center, campground, picnic area, and historic farm. In addition, the area is almost totally surrounded by the Jefferson National Forest, which only adds to its appeal as a destination for parkway visitors.
Farm is actually a restored 1930s farmhouse, restored to that era, that we have volunteers and park rangers in not-so-park ranger dress up there doing daily life activities as it would have been done in the 1930s here in the mountains.
This year the leaves really aren't changing colors a whole lot, right?
Well, they haven't gotten to that point yet. They are still turning. You can look and see how much green is still around here. You know, we're starting to see some of the yellows and some of the reds. There are actually some very nice individually red trees. One of the first triggers for leaf change is the day starting to get shorter and shorter, which kind of starts after September 23rd. And the second most important trigger is the temperature. Warm days, but cool nights without a frost. And so we're just starting to get to that, and so they're just starting to turn nicely.